Hello guys. Well, here's what I ended up with. Some of you wanted to see what I had. Well, it's a 2002 Intruder. When I bought it, believe it or not, it had 5,000 clicks on it. Why would somebody buy a bike with 5,000 clicks? I don't know. Don't have a clue. Anyways, I got it at a really good price. It was just like new. I've done a bit to it since. I'll tell you what I've done. I put on some Cobra pipes, made a little louder. Memphis Shades windshield with detachable brackets on it, which I really like. That's with the big bike, I didn't want to take off the windshield, but the little one I do. And this, it's just pop it off. Put on the little front bag. Put in an LED headlight. I like them. They really show up on the road. Gives you a little more visibility. The rear bag came with it. Front bag I had kicking around my place. Hadn't used it for years, and so put it on this one. It looks good up front. What else have I done to it? The seat. I got a new seat from Corbin. The only seat I ever had on a bike that was comfortable from the factory was my 82 Goldwing. I had a 750 Honda, uncomfortable. 82 Goldwing was great. 750 Intruder, I had one of these in the smaller form before, very uncomfortable. This was very uncomfortable, so I got a Corbin seat made up for me, and it's got leather tops and vinyl sides. It's not a Russell Day long, it's not as big of a seat, but I didn't want that big of a seat, it would overpower the bike. And Russell Day long, that's what they do. They make a big seat. That's their secret to success. You got more to sit on. This will be a lot more comfortable than the factory seat. Definitely. What else have I done to it? The pipes. I'm getting the backrest reupholstered. It's not on the bike right now to match the seat. I got this little chrome piece, big deal, on the drive shaft here, right there, just to cover the drive shaft. It does look okay. It's not a big deal. I like the little bags. I don't mind them. I'm not going as far, so I won't be carrying as much. Do I miss the old Kawasaki 1700? Yeah, it was very different when I got done with the restoration of it. A guy in Winnipeg is lucky enough to have it. I think he's very happy with it. I've talked to him once since he got it. I really like the bags I put on it. They just cut into that rear fender so nice. It looks so factory. With such a nicer bag than what the factory bags are. The factory bags are just a flower pot on the 1700s. Same material. They're real crap. The bags I put on were fiberglass. They were beautiful bags. And they just hooked up to the factory rails, everything just so beautifully. How I knew that from a picture, I don't know, but I knew it would work and work out better than the factory bags, and it did. So back to this. So I'm happy with it. It weighs in at 453 pounds compared to probably 900 pounds my Vulcan was by the time I got done with it. So it's a light bike. 13.6 seconds in the quarter mile. That's a fast little bike. Definitely. It's still got the stock tires on it from the factory. It was in a shed, so they're not cracking or anything. So I'll run them a year or so. Am I happy with it? Yeah, it's different for me. I've never had a light bike and a low bike to get on. This is very low for me. It was funny when I, the way I got into this, I thought my biking days were over. And my good buddy Colin, he said, take my 920 Yamaha Virago out for a ride. Really wasn't into it. So pull it out on the street and I climb on it. And I'm having a really tough time riding this bike because it's sitting so low and it's so light in comparison to what I've ever had in my life that I can't figure out what the hell's underneath my seat. I was having a tough time because of the lightness of it. And same thing when I got on this first few hundred yards, I had a tough time with it because just couldn't believe the weight was there. But I'm loving it. Yeah, it's very different riding a light bike than a heavy cruiser. I love it. It won't go as far. It does about 160 kilometers on a tank of gas. That's a small little gas tank on it. So you're stopping lots with this. You didn't with the old Kawasaki. You could get out there and cruise for hours. I'm getting, I forget the name of it, a cruise control for it. It's not electronic. It's the manual, but it's not one of the old flip latch ones. It's very different. And it's expensive. It's around Canadian $200 by time I get it up here. It works a little better than what the old flip down thumb cruise did. So I'll get that and I'll show you that once I get it. So you guys all know what I got if you got any other bikes. So I should let you have a hear of it. I've put a couple of thousand kilometers on it since. So here we go. I got to pull in the clutch on this one. So. So, it's a little louder than what the factory pipes were. I like the little pipes. I think it looks good on the bike. I didn't want drag pipes. As soon as you put the drag pipes on, you got to reject the carbs. And I didn't want to do that. These just slip-on mufflers. It's got a bit of a bark. Before I found it, it was like a in between a wash machine and a lawnmower, it sounded like. And you're getting all the engine noise right up at you. And it was a horrible sound out of the bike. Now I get it on the highway, I'm hearing the pipes, and it's a little more soothing. I like my old Kawasaki pipes, and I like the sound out of it. It was loud. It wasn't obnoxious to me on the bike. I really like the sound out of them. But this is what I got to ride because of my legs and so on, and I'll enjoy it. So, hope you enjoyed that. I think this is a timeless bike. They produced it for, geez, off the top of my head, I'm going to say practically 20 years in between the nameplate Intruder and Boulevard, which they put on it for the last 2 years, I believe, of the production run. This is oil cooled. It's a timeless bike, and on some of the models, this one you don't see it as much. The frame is painted red or burgundy or whatever the color, or green, whatever the color of the bike is. And it's kind of a timeless bike. It stood the test of time. It doesn't look old. If you have a CB754 from 1982, you know it's a 1982 CB754. This thing, you gotta guess at the age. You wouldn't guess that this bike is from 2002 and that it's 17 years old now. And it is, but you wouldn't guess it. It's timeless, and I think it will stand the test of time. It's not the Beatles, but it's my little bike.